Hi, Daniel Hall here, progressing, percolating, and evolving. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how much it costs to self-publish a book. There are five considerations: editing, cover design, interior, the ISBN number, printing, and whether or not you're going to have any illustrations or not. The key is how much it should cost to self-publish a book. I love writing and publishing and have, in fact, published a lot, literally over 2,000 books in my career. And one of the questions I get all the time is, how much does it cost to self-publish a book? And I know inferred in that question is, how much should it cost? The big problem in the publishing industry is there are a lot of predators out there. They'll give people a bad product even after spending all this money. So what I want to do in this video is circumvent that for you and walk you through some of the stages of books and what the costs have been for books that I've published myself. Let's jump in and talk about each one of these kind of in the sequence of books that I've done over the years. Now, I've published many books, but my first one was this boy right here, Speak on Cruise Ships. And this book, let's talk about how much it costs to do this book, and you're going to be very surprised to know it cost me nothing other than my time. So I designed the cover myself, did the typography on it. I used an ISBN number that was assigned by Amazon, did all of the interior of the book as well, and I had a friend copy edit it. And all of the images I took, so I didn't really need any other illustrations, so that was out. So this book was nothing, zero, did not cost me any time, or it cost me lots of time, but not any money. And that's certainly a way to go, and better than not publishing at all in most instances. But there are so many things that I learned along the way. Fortunately, this book had demand in the marketplace, and I ended up selling many, many, many of them. And I'm proud of it. I'm still proud of it to this day. Yes, it has its flaws. It's got its blemishes, but once again, it's helped like literally thousands and thousands of people. And that's really all that matters to me. Now, here's the thing I do want to say about the editing. Don't skip editing. Don't try to self-edit. Don't give it to your great aunt Mabel to edit for you because she used to be a proofreader back in the 40s. No, that's not what you want to do. If you're going to spend any money at all, have it professionally edited, or do what Stephen King says to do in his book on writing. Great book, I commend to you. If you haven't checked that out, check that out. But what Stephen King says to do is to simply give your manuscript to 10 people along with actual red pens and say, go wild, be ruthless at editing the book. I'm not looking for your approval. I'm not looking for nice comments. Be ruthless. Be as critical as you possibly can be. This is what you tell the 10 people. And of course, tell them that you're going to pay them in the form of an acknowledgement on the acknowledgement page of the book. People love to be mentioned in books. It is definitely a psychic currency that you could use for free to do that. And then you call together the 3 or 4 actual manuscripts that you get back, and then you pick and choose and you edit the book in that way. That is far better than trying to do it by yourself or getting Aunt Mabel to do it. That is the least expensive way to do that. Although the Speak on Cruise Ships book cost me zero because I did all the work myself, I do want to sort of walk you up to the next step with my real fast writing book. And the reason why I want to use this as a demonstrative aid here is because I call it the Fiverr book, because the interior was done by somebody that was not Fiverr, but was edited by a Fiverr person for $25. The cover, back, front, back, spine, Kindle, and audiobook cover, also done as a Fiverr gig for $25. And the first iteration of the book, I did the interior design of that book. So this book cost really nothing other than the 50 or say 100, under $100 for the entire book, until I decided I wanted to do the interior design, and then it cost me about $1,100 to have a super pro interior designer do the interior of this book. Now, the real interesting thing that I want you to understand about this is that with an interior like this, now I think this book looks great, and especially for the money I spent on it, but because I did spend a lot of money on the interior of the book, I loved it so much, and so much sort of effort went into the look and feel, the interior of this, that when I came out with the next book, which we spent significantly more money doing, called The Best-Selling Author, I took the interior of this book and I outsourced to, I believe, India to do the interior of this book. And because they had something to model, something to emulate, it was so much cheaper to do it that way. So with The Best-Selling Author here, we did a really high-end cover designer. This was several thousand dollars for the cover. The illustrator was a lot of money. I'm not at liberty to tell you how much that was, but it was a lot of money. It happens to be a New Yorker, a cartoonist for the New Yorker magazine. And what other things that I wanted to say about this? These books, this book and this book, and basically every book since my very first book, I had my own ISBN numbers. So that's the other thing that's going to cost you a little bit of money. That's going to be about, if you get them in blocks of 10, it's about $25 per number. So it's about $250 that you'll pay for that, but then you'll have it for your next, you know, 9 books or whatever. And that really makes you look so much more professional as well. The other thing about all of these books that we see here, printing, because I know that's going to be a big question for many of you. These are all print on demand. So you don't pay for printing until you get an order. Or this book, for example, I think if I buy it by the case, it's $2 to $3, somewhere in that neighborhood for this. It's a little bit more for the best-selling author. When you're using print-on-demand publishing, it's not all that much money. And here's really where I'm going with all of this, that if you are a new author, if you are new to this whole business, is there are so many predators in this space, and I want to protect you from those people. They'll take a book like your very first book and charge you tens of thousands of dollars just to get it in decent shape. And it's probably not going to even be in decent shape even then. Be mindful, keeping in mind what I've said and give with these prices that I've given you, so that you're not taken advantage of by these predators out there in the publishing space. So with that, I really, really appreciate you taking the time to watch. I certainly hope that you got massive benefit from today's video. If you did, I would really appreciate if you could Hulk smash that like button. And if you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe and hit the little bell notification as well. That will let you know every time that I upload a new video. Once again, one of the things I love about being an author is that I could help the people that I was put on this planet to help and be a blessing for them. Karmically, it comes back to you. That's why I want you to go out and be the blessing.